representation of magnetic field. Geometrically, magnetic field will be represented in three ways, and these are conventionally. So whenever you have examination, you have to remember the direction of magnetic field, and then equally spaced dot, second method of representation. Third, arrows marked at parallel distance. This is first method of representation, second, this is third. Whenever magnetic field is represented like this, it means the direction of magnetic field is perpendicular to plane, downward. When it is marked with that dot, then perpendicular to the plane, outward, right? When it is marked this, it is parallel to plane, right? What is perpendicular to plane and parallel to the plane? This is a plane. If I mark magnetic field lines on this like this, cross, 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 it means north pole is above this plane, south pole is down to this plane, and magnetic field lines are penetrating through this plane like this. Like this. Correct? If it is, assume this is an arrow and this is a tail. When arrow, you can assume, easily understand by assuming that vector is, magnetic field is a vector quantity and it is represented by arrow. Tip of the arrow is the pen, back of the cap of the arrow is your back tail of the arrow. So when it is entering like this, what will be the impression at the top of the layer of the tail? So tail is left here. When it is upward to the plane of blackboard or this paper, then what will be the impression at the top of the tip? Like this. See. Then this means it is outward to the plane of, and when it is parallel lines are marked, it means it is in the plane. Now let's see the trajectory of projectile, sorry, trajectory of charge moving in uniform magnetic field. Trajectory. Of moving charge in uniform magnetic field. Right? Let's consider a charge enters in uniform magnetic field with velocity v at right angle to the field. This is the field marked. Vertically downward, charge enters perpendicular to the field. Charge q is here. Direction of velocity vector is this. So where will it experience force? Use Fleming's left hand rule. direction of magnetic field is perpendicular to the plane inward. Watch it closely. Perpendicular, this is the direction of velocity. Then where is the direction of force? Upward, thumb. So it is acting upward. What do you think? The moment charge enters in magnetic field, will it start moving in the direction of force? Answer is no. Because it is already set into the motion. So one velocity vector and momentum vector is acting in this direction. So where will it move? In the direction of resultant, this charge will deviate little. So it has reached at position B now. The direction of velocity at this point B is this. So apply again direction of magnetic field, direction of velocity. See the direction of thumb. This is the direction of thumb. So the direction of force will be this side. Again, it would deviate more. Say it reaches at C. Then again check directs at C, the direction of velocity vector will be this. Check it again. This is where? This side. This side means this way. When we watch it closely, figure clearly indicates that at point A, direction of force indicates towards this point O. When charged particle reaches at B, again force is acting towards O. When charge moves from B to C, it moves again and acts towards point O. So every time when charged particle is moving in a magnetic field, force due to magnetic field is acting towards a fixed point. What kind of force is this? Think. And if you are not able to recall it, class 11th, then it is centripetal force. And centripetal force is equal to mv square over r. Even in class 11th, I told you, centripetal force is always obtained by a moving particle by other means. Any other type of force can act as centripetal force. Now, which force is acting here as a centripetal force? Magnetic force. Actually, the magnetic force is acting, and that is acting as centripetal force. Right? And what does centripetal force do? Centripetal force is a necessary force to move a particle in a circular path. It means trajectory of a moving charged particle in uniform magnetic field is a circular. So particle will move in uniform magnetic field in a circle, provided this is acting at an angle 90 degree. So here centripetal force Fc will act and particle move. But if particle, suppose condition differs, since it is moving in a circular path, so centripetal force is equal to what? Centri case 1. Centripetal force mv square over r is equal to qvv. 1v cancels. So r is equal to mv over qv. This will be the radius of the circle in which particle will move. And radius is decided by how many factors? You can call it as momentum. charge and magnetic field. You can play with this formula little, multiplying half mv square multiplied up and half qvv multiplied down. This is what? Kinetic energy. 2 kinetic energy. QVV is what? Force. So 2 kinetic energy over force due to magnetic field. Ratio of this is also termed measures the radius of a circle. Right? What happens if it doesn't enter at right angle? If particle enters in uniform magnetic field, at an angle theta, then trajectory is helical. Helical like this. Right? If it is not at right angle, then let's see, while magnetic force is acting on a moving charge in uniform magnetic field, how much work is done by the force? Work done by the force. Work done by magnetic force. In what path it carries charged particle? Circular. Centripetal force is your magnetic force. DL is the element of this length path, or DR you can say. Then work done, DW is equal to F dot DR, FC dot DR, that is FM dot DR cos theta. Since theta is 90 degree, this implies dW is equal to 0. No work is being done. And since no work is done, then from work energy theorem, change in kinetic energy or change in potential energy is equal to work done. This is zero. So no change in kinetic energy, no change in potential energy. So while charged particle is moving in uniform magnetic field under influence of magnetic force, no work is being done by this force on a charged particle. Right? Lorentz force. What is Lorentz force? Suppose you have developed a region in which electric and magnetic field both are existing. How can you develop electric field and magnetic field? Take a positively charged plate, another negatively charged plate. Electric field will be like this. Yes? And then in perpendicular direction you can set up magnetic field perpendicular to the plane. Suppose any charge is moving through this with velocity v, then how much force is experienced by it? Total force. F will be equal to force due to electric field plus force due to magnetic field. Force due to electric field is equal to QE. Due to magnetic field is QV cross B. So Q you can take common, E plus V cross B. This is called Lorentz force. This is called Lorentz force. So I can say if E is equal to 0, then Lorentz force is equal to Q V cross V. That is basically you have learnt right now as magnetic force. So a magnetic force can also be a Lorentz force under special conditions. Similarly, if you put B equals to 0, then again QE can be a Lorentz force. But you can go by velocity selection criteria also. Velocity selection, what is that? Even though the charged particle is moving with certain velocity through a region in which magnetic field and electric field both are existing, and you observe that charged particle does not deviate, right? So this can be possible only when Fe magnitude is equal to Fm. Magnitude and direction must be opposite. So QE should be equal to QVB. QQ cancel. So in velocity,